What?
Heading to Worlds, that is certainly greatly into the future, is Jhinne. Yeah, late invade. We haven't seen a late invade for a long time. Is they're not going to be spotted?
Kaz has no idea. This could be bad.
Yeah, he's by himself as well. There's the blast going. Surprise! Three people. Kaz finds the flash, but the flash from Molrong will guarantee first blood. And Jhinne, this
Griffin coming in third because, of course, they're against some of the lower teams. Is Lindorong looking for a solo kill? Good hook shot there from Rascal, but Kaz is going to come in and save the day.
This would be a very strong invasion trio. Rascal early in leaving the turret. Does he have hookshot up? You would assume so.
Yep, Grace is going to try and shift some sands over, but he's going to ult first, and that means Grace has his opportunity. He's trying to find hookshot positioning, but he can't get there, and second kill for Jhinne. No joy as Malrong's dirty farming, and Rascal's just not having a very fun time.
This camp counselor is about to put him in purgatory for a while on the top side, so the timeout room is being enacted.
Yep, Rascal trying to make his great escape, does use the flash to get out of the way. The Undertow and will be able to keep himself alive, but that is going to sacrifice his top outer turret, and all of the plates were eaten by Lindorong. Now on the bottom side, we're looking for it, but Tucson unable to get there. Kuz also going to be snared up. That Chains of Corruption was such high value. Kuz going to go golden, has the flash, will be a fat one to get out of there, but the teleport from Lindorong and another
really
kill delivered.
For Kingzone to navigate if they're against a Jhinne that's on form.
Watch the Chains of Corruption time here. It stops mid-grand entrance, the Rakan, and then the whole dive is scuffed. The first time was with no minion wave, the second time, perfect timing, but all arrested by Root's timing.
And not getting punished, he knows they have control of the bottom side of the map.
Kingzone have to play to what they know, which, as you can tell,
pretty comfortable there, as he's going to be very late to getting towards this inner turret. That's going to fall down, only barely getting to that turret in time, as the blockage there from Grace to make sure that Kingzone can't rotate. This is really clean play, apart from if that happens. Rascal makes his way in, and that's two kills already. One to the Camille, one to the Zaya. No more perfect game, and Grace has to use the Emperor's Divide defensively now. Towards the north, they're unable to save Nova because the Azir is in the mid lane, and Kingzone will move to the Baron.
Load up your VOD reviews later on and
watch
tell
this.
Us the exact
it's
moment.
It's beautiful until the Blade Caller from Death. He swings around, gets the stun, one member's deleted. Great deep teleport. And this is what a throw looks like, Atlas, all from the Blade Caller from Death.
Yeah, and as soon as that Emperor's Divide gets used, it means that the rest of
one person's instantly going to die. That's just how it's going to work. As Neon, he's got Valkyrie. That's one hell of an ability. As the flash forward, Root really wants to kill him, and they will. You're willing to invest that flash.
Because he was the one that stuffed up and walked up too far. We talk about that side lane outscale.
Yeah, looking for the 1v1. He's trying to get himself at exactly the right points as Lindorong has to use the solo stopwatch. Umbral Dash going to be utilized. The hook shot's there. Rascal stays on the wall. The flash to follow. The second is easy. The solo kill for the outscaling Camille.
Has now has his third item spike. Theoretically fourth, actually, if you include.
Okay, here goes Tucson. He's going to find four with the quickness. Nova should be going down with a Varus in his belly. That's going to condemn him to death as well. And Nova gets his flash back, instantly uses it, and he's still dead. The Emperor's Divide is down, and it's looking like Kingzone have found their team fight and maybe even the game, unless they want to take another Baron. There's only 18 seconds until that one comes up as well.
You call it a team fight, feels more like whack-a-mole for me. People die so fast, these carries that never should have had this gold. But one mistake leads to all of this, Atlas. It went exactly how we forecast. Sadly, we've seen this story before. We have to watch it once more.
Yep, and we had to talk about Jhinne and their possibilities to win, but now we need to talk about Tucson and his ability to engage. Good God. The Rakan looked beautiful in the moments where it worked, and Kingzone, they were losing, by a lot until they won the game.
Peace of mind, but they don't seem to work tonight.